Wake up, wake up, wake up! This is Jack Jetwash, your slipped disc jockey, on 3D TV at 7:30 on this good, good, good morning with your modern mother's muscle tone program of the air. Now, chins up, I mean chin up, index fingers out. Ready for your push-button finger exercises?
I'm ready.
1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Rest.
Okay, Mom, take 5. Good morning, and did you change your mind?
No, it's too cool to go swimming after school. Besides, you won't be home in time for dinner.
From Acapulco?
Oh, I thought you were going to Hawaii. Well, all right, if your father says yes.
Oh, he will. Daddy? Daddy, are you asleep?
Yes.
Thanks, Daddy. Daddy said yes.
Well, okay then.
Man, you're crazy, way out.
Crazy? Now, is that a nice thing to say to your mother?
Sure. I picked it up in ancient history. That's how teenagers used to say, I love you. Remember?
Don't be smart. You know I'm only 33. Well, what do you want for breakfast?
Nothing, thanks. I'm on a diet.
Wait a minute. Aren't you forgetting your bathing suit?
No, I haven't.
That's your bathing suit?
Uh-huh. It's the new instant stretch model, Mom. Just add water and watch the boys fizz.
If I was only 15 again. In fact, if I was only 32, 22, 32 again.
Hi, Mom.
Elroy, how many times have I told you not to wear your space boots in the house?
Well, I was just taking a shortcut.
And tracking up my ceiling at the same time.
I'm sorry, Mom.
I hate that thing!
Hey, Mom, what's holding up my egg?
Darn egg buttons always sticking. Ouch! No wonder I'm getting push-button fingers. Look at that. I set it for soft-boiled, and it comes out roasted.
Well, that's nothing. Yesterday, I pushed the scrambled button, and I got a hot fudge pizza.
George, breakfast is ready.
Okay, okay. Let me brush my teeth.
Hurry, George. You'll be late.
I'm hurrying.
Now behave yourself in school, Elroy.
I will, Mom.
The teacher said you were going on a field trip this morning.
That's right, Mom. We're studying the Siberian salt mines.
Well, keep warm, and don't pick fights with the little Russian boys. Goodbye.
Goodbye!
And don't leave your galoshes in Europe again! Well, good morning, George.
Morning, Jane. Oh, what is this, anyway?
What's it taste like, George?
Well, this coffee tastes like rocket fuel.
Then it's not coffee. It's tea. There's a cross-circuit in the Futuraca cycle.
Lumpy tea?
Oh, you got some of the oatmeal fallout. How's your bacon?
Raw.
And your eggs?
They're cold. I don't get it. When we first got married, you could punch out a breakfast like Mother used to make. Now you're all thumbs.
It's not my thumbs, and it's not me. It's this antique monster. I press this thing for meals, and hi-fi music comes out of the garbage disposal. I never know what's going to come out. See, George? We need a new one.
Jane, how can we get a new one? We haven't even paid for the one that replaced this one. Besides, I'm beginning to like my coffee with lumps in it.
Well, I don't. I want a new Futuraca cycle.
A new Futuraca cycle? Jane, we cannot afford it. No. Absolutely, positively, emphatically, beyond the shadow of a doubt, N-O, no!
George, are you trying to tell me something?
Forget it.
Why don't you ask your boss, Mr. Spacely, for a raise?
Because the boss is a penny-pinching old crab, that's why. Someday I'm gonna give that door a shot right in its electric eye. Pow!
Oh, I shouldn't have upset George. But if he only knew how I hate washing, ironing, vacuuming. Mother, I was just going to call you.
You were? Well, what did George do now, the big bully?
Oh, nothing really, Mother. It's just that housework gets me down.
Well, it's really none of my business, dear. So I'll give you some advice. Get a maid.
We can't afford it, Mother.
You don't need money. Charge it.
Don't you have to pay for a maid?
Not this one. I saw this ad on TV. It's a new service called You Rent a Robot Maid. There's even a one-day free trial in your home.
Free? Well, George couldn't complain about that.
I shouldn't have yelled at Jane. You know, maybe she's right. Maybe I should ask Mr. Spacely for that raise. After all, I'm a darn good digital index operator. You gotta have it up here to know how to start these things and stop them and start them again. Come to think of it, Spacely couldn't get along without me. I'll just march right in and I'll ask him for a raise right now.
But Stella, baby, I eat out every night.
I'm sorry, Cosmo. The girls need me for their protest meeting at the United Planets building. I'm sure you won't mind eating out again.
But Stella, and to think I married that woman 30 years ago because she could cook.
George Jetson is here, Mr. Spacely.
Butterfingers Jetson. Well, shoot him in. Why did I send for you, Jetson? You must have goofed up somewhere.
Oh, no, sir. I think you're fine.
You think? You think? Your machine is supposed to do the thinking, Jetson.
It's my wife, sir. She thinks...
Does your wife cook, Jetson?
Oh, yes, sir.
What does she cook, Like what?
Oh, like hash, meatloaf, soup, bones, beans.
Ah, good old-fashioned home cooking. I wish I were young and struggling again and eating home cooking like you.
Oh, yes, sir. Very struggling, sir. Two tiny children and one puny little wife. We're practically broke.
Wonderful. I'd love to meet them. And by coincidence, I'll be out your way around dinner time tonight. Any suggestions?
Well,
Fine. I'd love to have a home-cooked dinner at your place. I'll be there at 6. And now, back to work, Jetson.
What did I come in here for, anyway?
Busy.
You rent a maid. Hello? Anyone here? I'd like to rent a maid.
Yes. You have an appointment and your credentials.
Credentials?
Madam, you can't expect to get our maid without references.
But my mother told me.
Good enough. Any reference from any mother is all we need. Now, how big is your home?
We have 3 bedrooms.
A slum clearance project. Well, then you'll want to see our basic economy model. Rosie!
Coming, sir. Here I am, sir. Yes, sir.
The old girl's still eager, isn't she? But of course, very H-O-M-E-L-Y.
I may be homely, Buster, but I'm S-M-A-R-T smart.
I like her, and I'll take her.
Oh, thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
There is a one-day free home demonstration.
Oh, yes, of course. But we're not responsible for any damages to your home.
Come on. Let's go home, Rosie.
Yes, ma'am.
We can't guarantee her, you know.
Well...
Now, just make yourself at home, Rosie.
Yes, ma'am. I'll get right to work, ma'am.
Oh, that must be Elroy back from school.
Hey, where'd you get the antique jukebox?
Shush. Now say hello to our new maid, Rosie, Elroy.
Can you throw a forward pass?
I'm not sure, but I'll try.
thought you were going swimming.
Not with all these homework tapes I have to listen to tonight. Geopolitics, Esperanto, space calculus. I'll never be finished.
I could help you, Miss Judy. I'm wired for tape analysis. I should have all the answers for you in about 10 minutes.
Judy, this is our new maid, Rosie.
Am I ever pleased to meet you? Rosie, you are out of this universe.
Oh, boy, this traffic jam is all I need. With the food rack a cycle on the blink and the boss coming home to dinner, how am I going to tell Jane?
But how am I going to tell George, Mother? The kids just love Rosie.
Well, she's free for the first day, isn't she?
Oh, boy, can Rosie play basketball? Come on, Rosie, show me your hook shot.
Okay, here goes.
Wow, right in the basket.
Oh, dear, here comes George's saucer now. Goodbye, Mother.
I hate these compact saucers.
He'll come through that door any second, Rosie, and I want him to get a nice impression of you.
Yes, ma'am.
You're on your own.
Hello, dear. Oh, my aching back. I've got that compact saucer cramp. Oh, thanks, Jane. Oh, that feels good.
Hard day at the button, dear.
Oh, brutal. Brutal. I had to push the button on and off 5 times. That Spacely is a slave driver. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh, what?
Speaking of Mr. Spacely, what are we having for dinner tonight? Yikes! What's that? What's that doing here?
Rosie is our new robot maid, George.
Good evening, sir.
New maid. With the boss coming to supper and me trying to make him think we're poor?
But, George, she isn't costing us anything.
Out. Out. Beep, beep. Understand? Out.
She's completely free, George.
And she doesn't cost anything? Ha! Out. 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 Hey. Oh. Oh. You mean she's free?
For one day's home demonstration. But what's this about inviting Mr. Spacely when all we have in the place is leftovers?
I didn't invite him. He invited himself.
All right, break. When does your boss get here?
Any split second.
Where are the leftovers?
In the kitchen.
Never fear, while Rosie's here.
How am I going to explain needing a raise when I've got a luxury like that monster clanking around?
We'll just have to keep Rosie out of sight. I'll get it. Oh, hello. You're Mr. Spacely, aren't you?
And you, of course, are Mrs. Jetson. I must say you're a very young-looking 33, my dear.
Oh, I'm not my mother. I'm his daughter. Please come in.
Hey, lovely place. When do we eat?
Mr. Spacely, how nice. I'm Jane Jetson.
Charmed. What's Jetson talking about? You don't look puny at all.
Hi.
Howdy, son. Put her there.
It doesn't look like a crab's claw to me. Let's see you pinch some pennies with it, like Pop says you do.
What's that boy?
That boy is my son Elroy, Mr. Spacely.
I see. And what's that delightful odor?
Come and get it.
What's that?
That's the dinner bell.
A dinner bell that goes, come and get it? Best home cooking I ever tasted, Mrs. Jetson. May I ask what it was?
Oh, a specialty of the house, fillet of leftovers.
Fine dinner, Jetson. Fine family. Enjoyed every minute of it.
Oh, gee, thanks, Mr. Spacely.
You got a light, Jetson?
Uh-uh.
Allow me, sir.
Ah, thank you, my dear.
You're welcome, sir.
Pineapple upside down cake, my favorite dessert. Very efficient maid you got here, Jetson. Maid? How can you afford a maid on what I'm overpaying you?
Well, you see, Mr. Pennypinch, I mean, Mr. Spacely...
You got another job on the side, right?
No, sir, I...
You're moonlighting, aren't you? Admit it.
Quiet down, Shorty.
You keep out of this.
Now, look here, Mr. Spacely. These are nice people. They're giving me this chance so I don't end up in the scrap pile.
Jetson, where's my hat?
Down, boy, down. It's bad manners to leave the table until after you've had your dessert. There now. The pineapples are right side up. And you can go. After one more thing. The opinions expressed are my own and do not necessarily reflect those of my employers.
Boy, what a performance!
How about a cup of coffee to go with your cake?
No, Jetson. Don't move. I'd like to remember you just as you are. Fired!
Oh, some free home demonstration. It didn't cost us a thing, except my job, but it was worth it to see the expression on an old cakehead, Spacely.
Rosie, where are you going?
I know you folks can't afford to have me around. Goodbye, Miss Judy. Roy Boy, Mrs., and you too, sir.
Hey, Rosie, you can't leave now. You gotta teach me how to dribble a basketball.
Can't help it, Roy Boy. That's the way the ball bounces. Sorry I blew a fuse, sir. But what can you expect from wiring as old as mine? Well, thanks for the chance. See you all in the junkyard.
Oh, George, I feel awful.
Me too. Boy, if I wasn't 6 1/2, I'd cry.
Oh, now, come on. Let's be realistic.
I don't want to be realistic. I want Rosie.
Now, what kind of an idiot would call at a time like this?
Jetson, I apologize.
Oh, Mr. Spacely?
I got halfway home and started thinking that I got a big mouth and I shouldn't have fired you.
Well,
I want you back at work tomorrow. I had a better salary and a more reasonable hour. On time.
Oh, yes, sir.
And with a little extra in the pay capsule, you can afford that long-playing bulldozer you got for a maid. She may be sassy, but she makes the best pineapple upside-down cake I ever got clobbered with.
Yes, sir.
And we'll have to try the whole dinner bit again, if it's all right with Rosie.
Oh, yes, sir. If I could find her.
You mean she's gone?
Yes, sir.
Well, don't just stand there yes-siring me, man. Get out and find her. Go, go, go.
George, where are you going?
To find Rosie.
She's probably waiting at the space bus platform.
There she is now. Rosie, Rosie. We can afford you now. Oh, glad to have you aboard, Rosie.
Me too, sir.
George, is that you?
Sure, honey, and I found Rosie and I brought her back home to stay. She wants to know how much we charge her to let her work for us.
Don't be silly, Rosie. You are worth your weight in leftovers.
Thank you. And I love you people, too.
Hey, Rosie, is this how to sink a basket?
Very good, Roy Boy. Except you'll have to learn to let go of it.
Not tonight, Elroy. It's time to blast off for Dreamland.
Well, okay. If Rosie tucks me in and tells me about the cow that degravitated over the moon.
This I gotta hear, too. Will you, Rosie?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Good night, ma'am.
You too, George. Come on, all of you.
Yes, ma'am. Beep, beep.
Thank you, ma'am. Beep, beep.
Good night, ma'am, or mom. Beep, 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 beep.
Well, that's what I'm raising, a family of beep, beep nicks.